On the play, hopefully opponent doesn't surgical away of brainstorm. I think it already happened. Hopefully opponent does not miracle. And let's see. Basic island, bad news. Can be miracles. Yeah, like a second second island and pass because wanna leave mana tough for counter spell opponent can easily be show and tell. No, no, please. Please, I don't want this to happen. Oof. It's no miracle. Thank God. Alright, blue, white, Stoneforge. We successfully counterspell the Stoneforge. And now we are brainstorm locked. We need a. I don't know, I guess we need more counters. Sorry, I meant lands. At least one to be able to cast Mana Hero. Though I'm gonna not gonna play end of turn because I already knew the top two cards. Now I only need one card, so there can be a fetch land under them, and there was. I'm gonna shuffle away this and probably Nahiri. And then I'm gonna play Ponder. I'm gonna go for Tundra since I don't think my opponent is playing any kind of wasteland in his deck. Ooh, Blood Moon. This was good. I'm gonna put Ponder first so that I will pitch that to my force. So even though I can easily pitch Brainstorm. Right, nothing happens. I'm going to pass here. Just run Vendilion click end of turn and pass. Just play Vendilion game end of turn and pass. I don't want to run my Nahiri into what's most likely counter magic. Not a lot going on there. Let's see what this brainstorm does. Who do you like best, this or this brainstorm? I think I like this better. Mercadian Masks. Okay. Nothing happens after that brainstorm, so I'm happy with my only not click end of turn now. Or shuffling the top, so doesn't want to draw any of them. Just a counterspell here? Good, okay. And this was the bait. Now I'm gonna go with my Nahiri. Discarding Blood Moon. Playing Mountains Ago. I think that deck plays back to basics. If I'm not wrong. Like, it, there's no way. You fetch all those basics against miracles. He's definitely playing back to basics in his deck. But you know, enchantment not very good against Nahiri. So 5 mana Barrasco here. And 2 mana Stoneforge. Do I let this resolve or counter? I think I let this resolve. I have to just protect my Nahiri. I can just source the Stoneforge. Right, took a source of Fire and Ice. Ooh, Wasteland. Wasn't expecting that. Now he can strip me that. Yeah, that's... wasn't expecting that. I mean, I guess I can... Ooh, Squadron Hawk. Wow. I have to counter that. That's funny, but I do. I do have to counter that. Classic Force of Will on Squadron Hawk. Not something you used to see in Legacy. Alright, Ponder first to find the planes. I haven't found the planes. Those cards are nice. Though, I don't have any ways to deal with that Stoneforge Mystic. So I'll have to shuffle. Did I shuffle? Yes, I did shuffle. Choose to shuffle. Okay. I'm gonna discard Nahiri. And your spell snare. Alright, this is unfortunate. Unfortunately, I couldn't have taken the planes because of Skalindar. So, if I just had the wasteland there. Now he's able to attack my Nahiri. And wow, this is very bad. This is very bad. I guess it's not the worst because it's not gonna trigger the second ability on the Swords of Fire and Ice. So just going to deal 3 damage to Nahiri, and yeah, I mean, I can. I'm fine with that. I'm going to not Snapcaster Brainstorm. I'm just going to Snapcaster. Ooh, top. Just going to Snapcaster Ponder here. Because this digs better. Alright. No, this doesn't work because this deck only plays one Tundra. That's pretty bad. This is Kalintar. Wow, this is awful. Should play more Tundra maybe. Okay, let's shuffle this. Didn't click, not good. Let's discard I guess a spell snare. Come on, land. So bad. My opponent should have attacked me and redirect damage to Nahiri. I didn't see that. I didn't see that as well, but now I'm realizing. Should have done that. Okay, so it's dealing 2 damage to me but redirecting to Nahiri, so Nahiri's on 5. Really hope my opponent doesn't draw Squadron Hawk. Crucible of Wards. Okay. My lands are gone though. And Stoneforge Mystic. Okay. Now, man, let's see if I can find something. Alright, I found the Flawless Strand. And then I can mean I just don't care about the discarding drawing. Like I could have switched the top or anything, but I'm just going to shuffle the deck, so might as well just pass now. Swords, my Snapcaster. Okay. Musa was cheating. Yes, spell snare. Let's see if they have a way to deal with my swords. This attacking me, and that's it. Okay, so they have a Battle Skull. That I can answer with when they don't click. Okay. Crystal Ball, it's. Okay, no. Fortunately, my opponent chose to violate in now so that I can answer with when they don't click. That's the right play. After shuffling the deck, let's see what's the top. It's Nahiri. Okay. think I'm drawing spells near. Now I will exile this. And then pass. They're clicking draw step, let's see what they have. I felt so ahead basically the whole time this game, but now Butter School I think will make me a little worse. Yeah, definitely taking out True Nemesis since I don't have any way to deal with that once it's in play. Oh, I have explosives, I guess. Yep. Where's the germ going? It's going to go Nairi, definitely. See if I found some answer for that. Oh, Blessed Lions. Not exactly an answer, but will do the job for one turn. Yeah, it's pretty bad that I don't have where there in my sideboard. All right. Chase. Chase resolves. Brainstorm. Okay. Bolt, bolt. Yeah, now I'm I think I'm slowly dying to this Butter School, source of card advantage, and just the pressure with the swords that I can't keep up. Okay, now my opponent's looking for a counter, I guess. And he found force. Let me see if there is a counter spell as a third card. No, that's just concede. This video is lasting so long. Okay, so Pithy Needle should be fine. Rhythm Metablast is good. What I don't like. I guess I don't like Blood Moon, I don't like Blessed Alliance, and like kind of like everything else. What can I cut at this point? Explosives. Explosives not exceptional, but can answer the swords. So I guess this is okay. Let's go with this. Alright, on the play for game two, the hand was not great, but we have the combo. Basic Kylan, Fetchland, Brainstorm, which basically makes you keep every hand. Pithy Needle is not exceptional, this matchup, but it's definitely, like, fine. Not great, let's say. Don't have a Flawless Strand or already means that you find my Basic Island, so I'm gonna get a planes. Sorry, I said I'm gonna get my basic planes, so I'm gonna get Basic Island here. The next turn, I'm gonna go ahead and fetch land again. Go Brainstorm fetch land again. I guess I'll go for the Tundra Swords now. Okay, they have a Bodice Coil in their hand. Bodice Coil. Think about when this combo was legal in standard at some point. I was starting to play Magic, and I could just take this card, which was the huge things ever with this card. It did not last long. Now my opponent is lasting long instead, so I'll pause. Oh, my opponent went for the Force. Pitch Force. That's aggressive. That's so aggressive that will make me go Snapcaster Swords. See if they have another Force. I hate that play by my opponent. The matchup used to go very long, and I have plenty of Swords effect. He also saw me playing Bolt. Okay. Got rid of the swords, I guess, in a very, very fair Bolt trade. He basically spent three cards, and we spent two, and we have a 2-1 in play. I'm happy with this trade. Attacking for two. And pass. Okay, opponent doesn't have anything. Spin the top. Nahiri the Harbinger. Alright, I'm gonna draw Nahiri. And I just jam it. Don't really care about the other two cards, and I'll probably just discard Scalding Tarn if that resolves. All right. This was maybe a bad timing for Nahiri, because my opponent is now maybe tapping out for Bodice Coil. But I figured that if that resolved, I would have won the game with just blocking and minus eight. No blue pitch. It's pretty unfortunate. Can't go. I kind of like keeping the Force. Okay, I have a plan now. I'm gonna go Pithy Needle name Bodice Coil, and then we'll block plus Bolt on the turn. This way, I kind of lock down the Bodice Coil. This is something. I have to find a blue card. All right. Don't have any answer to this, so it's kinda doing it. Drawing Fetchland now. I want to find Swords or Snapcaster, so I think I can give another shot of just playing this. Okay, not find it. So shuffling, looking at the top three again. That's a sword. Could have waited another turn and have the brainstorm in my hand to force back. That was probably better. As things stands, I have to find a yeah. But I guess it was not good. My opponent already had two force blade, and I'm a little low. I'm a very low life, so I. And also, swords make him draw a card. So I think overall, it's okay. Going like this. Yeah, this is over. Alright. Concede the game. We completed the league with 2-3. The deck was, I mean, it's not a tier 1. I guess it's a good option if they ban Counterbalance. Or Temris, but they will never do that. So, it was just a different deck as I like to record. And obviously, you have to add Wear Tear in the deck. If you want to play a deck with 15 cards, that I recommend you that. And we didn't play against any combo deck. I wanted to see that matchup. I think the matchup is pretty good. Oh, we played against Nahus in turn 1 and we lost. But I believe the matchup is good though. They had a pretty good game tree. Okay, this was a pretty long recording, so I hope you had fun. Next time, I think I'll be still recording Modern Legacy. You know, I like those formats. Maybe Legacy way more than Modern, but I guess there's that. Okay, so have a good weekend, and I'll be back for next week. Bye.